All right, what's up, everybody? Welcome to today's short, unscheduled stream. I had to end the stream early, about an hour early last night, because as some of you know, I was complaining about some shoulder pain. And just to give you an idea, right? So, hey, actually, let me go to the pause screen, and then I'll say hi to everybody who's in chat. So, you see this vice grip, right? You know, I was rubbing this area. Imagine taking this and like placing it right there, right on this like soft tissue area. That's what it felt like pretty much since the turtle fight where we had to flip him on his back. And so towards the end of the stream, and when I got lost and we died in the waterfall, I kind of started to lose steam, right? I'd been getting tired from streaming, and I was in a lot of pain, and it was starting to get really hot in my room. And so the whole quality of the stream kind of started to tank, which is why I ended it, because this stream is really important to me, and I really want to make it entertaining for everybody who watches. And I could just tell that I was starting to become so focused on the pain that I couldn't even think of anything to just normally talk about. So that's why we ended it. But I owe an hour and 15 minutes plus that boss that stunlocked us, bullied us, if you will. So that's what we're going to go do. And then this will just be a short stream, and then we'll pick up our regular schedule tomorrow. Let me switch back here. So you got Edward of Wappleting. Oh, did you change it? Edward Wappleting. Okay, I thought it was Edward of Wappleting. Awesome, right when I was getting bored at work, Rewind came to the rescue. Yo, man, hey, don't get in trouble for watching at work, but thanks for showing up. Oh, man. So, hey, by the way, Ed, because I know that we're in a Discord with other stuff. I also have a Discord if you would choose to join that. So in any case, we ended because, like I said, we got stunlocked. Please move, horse. I need to get on the way. We ended because I got stunlocked by the bull saber-tooth-like boss. And, you know, like I said, between the pain of my shoulder and the heat of the room and just having already streamed for almost 5 hours, that just kind of drug on me and wore on, and I could already feel that I was going to start getting maybe a little gripey, and that's not the energy that we want to have here. So now we're going to go do it. You know, and I really think that even though we had to do that last night, it was really important to this stream, because being a new streamer, right, it's important, actually being new in anything, right, it's important to learn your limits and recognize your limits and what you're willing to deal with, and where you kind of need to understand where to draw the line. What I've been noticing is that usually on Saturdays when we do, you know, the streaming until midnight is right about that, oops, I guess I'm going the wrong way again. Hold on, let me find the way around. I gotta reorganize my horse. But I noticed that right towards the end, maybe about an hour before the end of the normally scheduled stream, we tend to start having people in chat drop out. And that's not a complaint or anything. It's just, you know, something I've become aware of. So maybe until we get some more people that, you know, hang out in the stream and whatnot, maybe we should only keep the Saturday streams to 4 hours instead of 6 hours, because it's usually not an issue on Friday. But you know, I thrive on the energy that talking to my viewers gives me. And that isn't a call out to any lurkers or anything, because I know that, I mean, I'm personally, like, if I'm not streaming, I'm more often than not a lurker in other streaming channels, right? You just want to sit back, relax, and watch the streamer do their thing. But sometimes the streamer, needs to get some energy, right? Like the spirit bomb from Dragon Ball Z, right? Like, you know, just chat, send me your energy. And when we start losing a lot of people that are normally talking, you know, it kind of takes away a point of being able to continue the conversation, continue the commentation, and that in addition with everything else I already mentioned was too much. So, but it's important to recognize. It's important for me to have learned that. You know, I'm still trying to find my way in this whole streaming community and being a streamer, entertainer, content provider. So it's good that we're getting this stuff out of the way now, right? We're learning it early. It's not something to be ashamed of, right? You just got to know when to pull the plug. And then you do a makeup stream. So what's going on at work, Ed? How you doing, man? I'd say the other thing too, right, is that's going to be the next hurdle to get around. I mean, we kind of mentioned it before on stream, but what do you talk about when you run out of things to talk about? Right? Like, actually give me a second before we continue that, because I always end up missing this drop down here. You've cleaned exactly one car and you close in an hour? Nice. Hey man, hey, at least it's been a an easy Sunday. That was actually really surprising to me. LDW said that he dropped out of the, oh man, I was right by it. He dropped out early last night because he said that he had to go to work early. And I was like, am I missing something? Tomorrow is Sunday, and it's just like, I guess when you work for so long in a field that I have, you don't, okay, of course, you're making this real difficult. You don't work on Sundays, and so it kind of threw me for a minute. I was like, tomorrow's not Monday, is it? If tomorrow's Monday, then I've got a big problem. But at least you've had a nice, easy Sunday. But to pick up what I was saying, right, is in order to do streaming stuff, right, you got to be able to stream to an empty room. And part of that is, like, you know, you try to look up things and say, okay, well, what do you talk about? And it's like, well, you can literally talk about anything. Think of things you're passionate about. And I think I've noticed in my older age that, like, I actually need to reevaluate what I'm passionate about. Because if you were to ask me, it's like when you ask somebody, like, you know, hey, man, what kind of music do you like? And then you just, bam, instantly forget everything you've ever heard in your entire life. And I feel like that's the same way when someone's like, hey, man, what are you passionate about? You didn't have to be in on Sundays until noon. We're one of the very few car dealerships open on Sundays. You know, that is strange. I don't think I've ever tried to go to a car dealership on a Sunday, but that makes sense. I don't really know why a car dealership would need to be open on a Sunday. I mean, most places are closed on Sundays anyway, unless you're a restaurant. Do you guys offer food? Are you like one of those car dealerships where it's like, hey, by the way, after we finalize this paperwork, you can like sit down and eat wings? We have a couple of those around here, although they're more like gas stations. But basically it's like I think they're called like gas and goes or something like that. It's always struck me as kind of strange. It's like we have a sit down restaurant at the gas station, and if I evaluate everything associated to a gas station with basically the gas station bathroom, and so I imagine like the same cleanliness level for the food, and I'm just like, no, I think I'm good. All right, so let's see. The problem that we had with this guy last night, I'm gonna talk about this before we get started, but the problem that we had with this guy last night, on top of everything else I already mentioned, is it took me a minute to realize that I had to climb the pillar. He knocked me off. A torch fell out. I had the torch. I scared him. I scared him off this ledge. He ran back around and jumped over. The torch was gone, and then I couldn't get another one. And then I got stunlocked into the wall. So let's see if this goes any differently. He's got a pretty badass entrance, too. Alright, now don't bully me this time, please. I should turn up my volume a little bit. Alright, and we're off. Ugh, and I'm already getting bullied into the wall. Yeah, kinda. Sundays usually serve as a catch-up for cars that sold the week before but aren't going anywhere. Alright. But yeah, so this is the problem that I ran into last night, right? Like, the amount of time that it takes to actually get up and recover is just enough time for him to do his thing. And it's not great. Alright, now he has to hit this to knock me off, and then a torch should come flying out. Right? So there it is. So I need to grab this torch, or get knocked the fuck out. You haven't played this game in full yet? Well, I think we've beaten 10 Colossus. We would definitely end up finishing it sometime soon. Can I please get up, sir? I'd like to grab my torch, please. Damn, dude. Uh-oh, it's rolling the wrong way. Okay. Alright. So now I've got the torch. And he doesn't like the torch, although he knocked me in a good spot. But yeah, Ed, okay, the camera is not helping me out here. Don't spoil this for yourself. But so now I have to get back up here. Excuse me. So this way I can light it, which is what I did the last time, but then the torch ended up going away. So this guy doesn't like the fire. Right? And so I figured that you kind of had to, like, back him up and off the ledge, but he doesn't necessarily fall. I mean, he falls off the ledge, right? And so then he's down there, but then what do you do from here? I don't see any green spots. I don't know if I'm supposed to go down here with him. But he's gonna, like, smack me here pretty soon. So, I mean, I kinda got him. See, like, this one. Now this is how we get payback, right? Oh, you'll be listening? Alright. So this is how we get payback. Oh, now I guess there I go for talking. I was gonna say, you stun me, like stun like me, I'm gonna hold you against the wall. Alright, but I'm not entirely sure. Uh-oh, and now the fire's out, so now we're really screwed. Alright, so let's run back around here. I don't know what you're supposed to do if you lose this torch, because that's what happened the last time. At some point, he starts, like, he does emit what looks like a weak spot in his back that you're supposed to... It looks like that's where you're supposed to try to shoot, but I wasn't able to switch soon enough, I guess. Unless I'm supposed to push him out into the open over there. Which we can try to do that as well. Alright, so now that he's back, let's see if I can move him the other way. I just need you to back up a bit more, please. Keep going. Keep going. Let's see if we can push him off the other ledge. Although I imagine that if we do that, he'll probably just run back around unless that's a special spot for him to fall, which it doesn't look like, although it looked like it was kind of special. Because I'm wondering if this might be like the turtle fight, right, in the arena, where if we knock him off a high enough ledge, he might just kind of fall over and then we can go get him. Yep, there we go. Looks like that's what I was supposed to do. Ooh. Okay, so now, see, now we're making progress. Now we're cooking with fire. Okay, just go down, please. Although, I guess it wanted me to run like a normal human being around. Poor little guy, he fell down. Yo, what's up? Welcome to the stream, LDW. That doesn't look colossal. You want a refund? Hey, man, listen, get your, talk to your dealership manager and tell him that you want a refund and let me know how well that goes. How's your day been, LDW? You said you had to go to work or something like that, right? Sir, I would very much like to climb onto your butt. Sir, excuse me, I'd like to climb on to your back, please. Can I not grip onto him that way? Alright. Oh yeah, that's right, so we can do hugs here too. And also, Ed, so my mods basically have been busy while I've been playing. They made a whole bunch of, I think I have to run him into a wall, probably. He made a whole bunch of mod commands, so we have a magic 8-ball in chat as well. Oof. Oh, please get up. Well, it's very doubtful that he should stream today. Alright, so I think I might end up getting stunlocked here again, which is no bueno. Don't hit me, please. Oh, no. And see, the camera doesn't help, because I want to keep an eye on where he is, and the camera keeps trying to reorient. Please roll. Okay, well, he missed, which is good. Alright, so where do you have to be? Is there, like, another spot here? Damn, dude. I'm getting my ass kicked again. 8-Ball said no streaming, Ed. Well, you gotta listen to the 8-Ball, Ed. Okay, so he's not deterred by the water. I just tried to glitch through the ground. We're gonna probably die here, but at least we made more progress. It's Mother's Day, not likely, unless we get done with that stuff quickly. That's fair. That's right, today is Mother's Day, so if you haven't wished your mother a happy Mother's Day yet, definitely go do that. Alright, so how do I get on his back? Because it looks like I should try to be able to climb his shoulders. But it's not exactly working great for us. And it said very doubtful? Yeah. It's a non-zero chance. Oh man, I need like an extra half second to try to get up before this dude beats me up again. So I wonder if I have to like somehow lead him, do I have to lead him back up and try to knock him down again? Because that would seem kind of counterproductive. Like that's a really long way to try to lead this boss. There's gotta be a way up onto him. Like it looks like I should be able to jump up and grab him. But it's not letting me do it. He's got quite a swagger going on there too with that tail. Look at me after tails again, right? You did yours early in the morning? Nice. Uh-oh, camera kind of messed me up a little bit. Oh my god, I don't know if you guys saw that, but I kind of took that horn like right to the lower abdomen area. That would have hurt a lot. Alright, I don't see any green... any green spots on them that I should shoot with my bow. I don't see anything else necessarily in the environment for me to use either. But climbing on them is not working. So I'm gonna use this minute while I got knocked the fuck out to look. Alright, well, there's another death. Oh, I don't even have it open. Hang on a second. Hold on, chat. Don't panic. I'll get the deaths. There we go. By the way, LDW, I tried. I went, before I started this stream, I tried to, fix. Yeah. I tried to fix the, like, the center portion. For where the numbers are, and it would not do anything. So it's actually labeled as centered and centered, vertical and horizontal, but no matter what, unless there's three digits, it won't be centered. So there's literally nothing I can do about it. That's just the way the stream label works. Alright, let's do this again. And then I'm gonna try to just sneak grab this without getting hit. I don't know if I can... Oh no, he takes so long to grab it. Alright, cool. Alright, so this is the goal. The goal is to not get bullied this time. Alright, so we got that. We need to get over here. We need to push him off the ledge so we can knock off all the stuff. And his tail looks grabbable, and we might need to try some Super Mario 64 BS. I'd like if that was a thing, but part of me kind of feels like I didn't hurry fast enough down there to try to get on top of him. Or he stays down that way until you wake him up. Yeah, bullied, you get it? Yeah. That's what it is. Actually, it was actually kind of funny when this boss first showed up. So I like to try to guess like what may have been the artist's inspiration for these different beasts. And so when he first showed up, I was like, well, he looks kind of like a cross between a boar and a saber-toothed tiger, but I am absolutely going with a bull. Oh, did I say bull? I meant boar. Boar and a saber-toothed tiger, but now I'm going with a bull. So clearly I have to get up there and on that spot, but the thing is that so I think he's gonna stay there until I get down there. Or, you know, faceplant down there. Looks like a Mech Warrior reject. I actually don't know what Mech Warrior is. I don't think I can shoot him from here either. Or maybe I can. I mean, this can't be the way that I'm supposed to kill him. This can't be the way I'm supposed to kill him. I'm supposed to run up here and then just keep shooting him with arrows in his back. That'd be like the most cheap way to do this. You can cheese it that way? Well, I don't really want to cheese it. It's just this is what's working. I really would like to figure out what the mechanic was supposed to be, but none of the climbing stuff was working. It didn't look like there was a solid way to get onto him. So, I mean, so LDW, go ahead and drop me a hint. Where am I supposed to grab him to climb him? Like, is he climbable, or do I have to, like, do some other something or another to, like, knock him over? Again. Because otherwise, I'm not sure. I gotta keep shooting him in the butt. Which, that would make this a very, very hollow victory. Give me a Dark Souls type hint? All right. Oh, don't say get good. Have you tried jumping? Well. I mean, I'm... Uh-oh, camera. Uh-oh. The camera's on his side. There we go. And I saw what you said about Mech Warrior. I just don't really have a chance to read it here at the moment. All right, so this is like a rodeo, right? So how many points do I get for holding on tight, right? Do I get like super different amount of points for not getting bucked off? I don't think he'll let me get the charge up. I think I'm gonna run out of grip before he lets me get the full charge. All right, come on, just give me a second here, bud. Oh boy, tanks on legs, nice. I'll read the full thing that you wrote here in a second. I'd like to get one stab, but by the time this boss is all about, like, I think timing with this boss is everything. So we're just gonna kind of have to wait here. Although now that I have a minute, let's see. Mech Warrior is a great game series. It's been dead for a while. It's gonna be dead like I'm about to be dead. Recently got a strategy game called Battletech, and it's getting a fifth game at the end of the year. Oh, nice. Is that a, is that like a tabletop RPG? Or is it like an actual video game? Alright, we're gonna have to let go after this. I wanna get one more stab, but then we'll have to let go. I wonder why he led us back here. I guess because I figured it out. I wanna get one more stab, dang it. Let me get the stab. There we go. Then we'll run back up here and try to jump on him as he comes over. Whoops. It's R2 to grab, please. Battletech is a turn-based strategy video game. That is in the only recent game was Mech Warrior Online. Alright, I'm gonna have to... I think I probably have to jump off of the thing. I don't think I can just grab him from here. I think I have to jump off the top. There's also Tabletop RPG that was using it. Nice. I've never heard of it. I mean, that isn't really surprising nowadays. Maybe back in the day, it was a little surprising if I hadn't heard of a game because I was just so into video games back in the day. Not that I'm not now, but it's just there's so many video games and so many indie games and everything like that, right? Like, I mean, like when this game came out, right? Like everybody was talking about this game. When God of War came out, everyone was talking about God of War. But, you know, there's just so many games that come out now that there's no way to know every game. There's, like, barely any time to stab this dude. Have you played the tabletop RPG of that game, Ed? Apparently, Ed never completed this game in full, but he knows the ending, LDW. Did I miss? Am I missing? What's going on here? That's kind of strange, because like I was pretty sure that I hit him in the right spot, but it made a ting sound and not a hurt sound. But there's only one thing on him, so... The only edition that came out released in the early 90s sometimes, well before your time. That's fair. There we go. Now I'm doing more damage. I don't know what was going on before. I thought I had it, and it just, it said no. Like that, right? I mean, can you only hit him once per, like, shape? Because, like, I don't think that did damage either. So what do I have to do? Hit him and then... Oh no, that hurt him. That's strange. It's like I'm still in the right spot, but sometimes it just doesn't register. It's almost like there's a cooldown between when he can take damage. Like that, right? Like, why didn't he take damage there? Or maybe it has to charge up just a little bit more. That's probably it. You're working on a tabletop strategy game using the universe, the RPG focused on characters as opposed to mech battles. That's still kind of cool, though, especially if you're a fan of the series. One of the things that I always loved about certain video games is when you find out more about the characters themselves, right? So, you know, kind of like what you were describing. That was too soon. Wow, dude, I just did a cartwheel in the air. Like what you're describing, but, you know, then you can actually start using those characters. Like, let's see, I used to be really about reading the Magic the Gathering books, and then when I could find the cards, right, I would build an entire deck around, like, the book, just because I thought it'd be kind of cool. And the same thing as, like, World of Warcraft and, like, all the Blizzard franchises, right? And Heroes of the Storm, you can play as all the different characters and heroes. which I think is kind of cool. Flavor decks are super fun. Yeah. I haven't played Magic in, like, a really long time. Like, a really long time. They tend to be bad, but they're fun. Yeah. I think one of the decks that I made, and this is during the, I want to say the Ravnica series, maybe? It was when they were big about having, you had the Leonin characters, right? Like the Lion and Lioness characters, the Anthros. And they had like a whole bunch of those equipments and like everything was like part metal and whatnot. I made a Leonin deck and it actually did pretty good. And then I tried to capitalize on that by making a Luxodon deck, which had the elephant guys, and that did not do good. I don't know what Ravnica stood for. All right, I need to get out so I can get some more crypt. Because now we have 3 Ravnica blocks? Wow. Yeah, all I can tell you is that from what I remember is that it was when they first introduced the equipments, right? Like they're the artifacts with the silver borders instead of the brown ones, and then they and then you would just equip your character with it, so you could basically make entire equipment decks that gave like +1/+1 or +1/+2 depending on what it was. I wonder if this boss was like purposely designed to take a long time, like they like ran out of an idea for this boss or something. Because it just... There's almost... Wow. Okay, I don't know what we did there. That's kind of strange. Did you guys see that? He still had, like... I mean, I'm not complaining about the win, but, like, he still had that much health left. And I only did, like, a minor charge. So that's kind of strange. But, hey, we did it, right? And so this is the way that last stream should have ended. And again, I do apologize for the lack of quality that we started having there towards the end. But I'd like to think that we just redeemed ourselves, so. I also just got a whole bunch of water up my nose. Good news, though, it didn't stain the shirt. Oh, man. Oh, let me tell you something else too while we're doing this. So here's the thing, right? So as you guys know, I drink tea all the time. Well, I went to get a second cup of tea, right? And I had meant to bring my stress relief tea, right? Because, you know, my shoulder was hurting and whatnot, and this is kind of relaxing, but not really overly sleepy, right? It's relaxing but not sleepy. Okay. I also have this one for when I have trouble sleeping, which this is basically the Benadryl form of a tea bag, and this is what I drink, and they taste sort of similar, so I didn't recognize it. And so you could say, you know, but how can you not have known the difference? One's purple and one's blue. Turns out in the dark these look the exact same, and I thought I grabbed it from the bowl that had this one, but I actually grabbed this one. So on top of everything else that we mentioned and me already getting tired, I took the Benadryl form of a tea bag. So it was not great. I sabotaged myself. My shoulder was in pain. I ran out of things to talk about. It was too hot in my room. It was not great. It was not great. And yeah, the nose. Guessing everything went to shit after you left. Pretty much. Like that's when everything started really taking a weight on me. And then yeah, my nose just took the blow for my shirt. Absolutely. Alright, let's go, let's go see where the next one is. I'm like I said, this was really only a makeup stream to, you know, take out the boss that we just killed, and we've still got about a half an hour and 15 minutes, so about 45 minutes. We might have enough time to do another boss. By the way, I'll mention it now, although I'll probably mention it again next stream, but I'm not sure what the next game is going to be after this. LDW, I know that you've been pushing hard for Diablo 1. I agree that I think Diablo 1 would be pretty awesome to play. But we're going to have to take the Thursday's art stream to actually create the standard def panels of everything that's going on screen. So I'll have to wait until after Thursday, and then we'll move on to Diablo 1. But so I'm going to need a game, a shorter game to play in the meantime. And honestly, after completing Shadow of the Colossus, which we should probably be able to do Monday, I'm thinking we can do Ico. Because I do have that. I mean, I'll have to put it on the PlayStation 3. What about Hollow Knight? I haven't played that either. But I don't own that either. It's shorter. Is it shorter than Ico? Because I know Ico has like a... Okay, Mr. Horse. Actually, you know what? That's probably a good idea. I should probably check again. Alright, nope. I was going the right way. We might play Ico because I know that game can be beaten probably on Tuesday in a 4-hour stream. Although, given the fact that I haven't played it, you know, maybe that would make it end up being longer, but we need to have the standard definition before we can do something else. Or maybe we'll just do a game that's like more roguelike. This way we can kind of just stop whenever. You know what? We might end up doing that. I might pull out the Xbox and we'll just play some Dead Cells while just to kind of push us to Thursday, create the standard definition panel on Thursday, and then we'll go ahead and move into Diablo 1. Because then that'll also probably give me enough time on Wednesday to figure it out and set it up. Join the STS bandwagon? Join the STS bandwagon. I don't know what STS stands for. Wait a second. Hang on. We got a... Horse, I need you to stop, please. Where's the brakes? Someone show me where the brakes are. Slay the Spire? We could. I do own it. Okay, so here's what happened last stream, Ed. Since you weren't here. I was trying to get to where we just were, and I went through this forest, and I fell into the river, and I don't know if you can see it, but you see there's a lake, there's a waterfall there. I got sucked right off the waterfall and into the water. Yeah. And I was just in the complete wrong area. And then the horse doesn't like to do more than like a light canter in this area anyway. Yeah. Well, I mean, you guys, I don't know. I'm all for giving chat what they want. So, I mean, it's kind of up to you guys. Do you want to see Slay the Spire, or do you want to see Dead Cells? I personally think that Dead Cells would probably be a little bit more entertaining. So that's kind of got my vote. But, okay, horse, you're messing me up here. But, Slay the Spire could be fun too. I haven't played with that new robot character. The last time that I played Slay the Spire was when they still only had two characters, and then I think I got every card for the rogue that throws the shivs. And the bigger guy. You've got a lot of games that you could suggest, but you don't know them without looking at your computer. That's also fair. Is this the makeup stream? Yo, what's going on, Billy? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, so, just a quick recap. We ended up ending about an hour and 15 minutes early last night because I was in a lot of pain and a lot of other bad things happened. The good news is that from all the suffering that happened last stream, I kind of know my way around this forest. So I have an idea where we're going. But yeah, we already took out the boss that was bullying me from the last stream. And now we're going to go just see what the new boss is. Need to watch someone play Slay the Spire that doesn't cheat. I mean, that would be me, but... You missed him applying foundation and blush. Yeah, thanks for the host, Billy. Appreciate it, man. Also, Billy, and also Ed. So, we have a new thing whenever anybody follows this channel. They are... I'm just gonna let you know because you guys might not be here since I'm not growing at like an exponential rate, but we're just basically gonna continue the whole duck like running joke on this channel. So anybody who follows is a duckling. So you guys are also duckslings. You guys were pre duckslings, but now you're duckslings. And then I think at some point maybe Thursday if we finish making the standard definition panel early, I might be able to pull in a picture of a duck into Illustrator, and then we might make an actual duck, and then I might be able to animate it in After Effects. I don't know, I'm kind of just spitballing here. But we could do that and animate it, and then we might be able to have a GIF too, so then whenever somebody follows, it'd be like, so-and-so is the newest Duckling, and then we'll have it. I kind of owe that to Timbit. I gotta remember to thank him for that. Like, that's kind of giving this channel some comedy that I think it might need. Oh, you're busy GMing? How'd that go? What did you play? Tell me everything about D&D. I love hearing about D&D. Plus, this is a good time for me to look at it too, because all I'm going to do is swim forever and a day. Proto Duxlings? There you go. So anybody who joined before yesterday, you are a Proto Duxling. Alright, then we should just be able to jump. Well, I think I'll climb down the wall. I died last time because of this. And whoop. Oh boy, do you have stories about D&D? Yo, share them, dude. Actually, Ed, am I getting stuck? First of all, I want to know. Okay, let me pause the game real quick. I showed this on stream, but I don't think that you were here. But when I was playing D&D, I saw this on Amazon, so I got this. And this is my, let me hit this real quick. So check this out. It's for using for holding dice. But it's a mimic. And it came with a cool little, dice rolling to roll the dice. But I love it. I stopped using it because it started getting a little wear and tear on the edges. So now it just kind of sits here and keeps me company. You were there for it? All right. I didn't know. I didn't know if you were there for it or not. So I didn't know that you were into D&D until now, so I wanted to show you. So your party got back into town. You're going to get sucked good. Oh, shut up, LDW. Party got back into town after digging through an overgrown crypt in the forest. Ooh, nice. Sounds like skeletons. Right? Was it skeletons? It's almost always skeletons. If you're talking about a crypt, it's skeletons. The commander of the town guard is preparing to execute the kingpin of local crimes they'd help lock up named Redcloak. Well, that sounds like everything is going good so far. Who messed it up? Was it the party that messed it up? That's always what it's been in my experience. It's always somebody in the party that just completely derails the whole campaign. Always. That's kind of weird. I think I accidentally turned my sound down. I think, if I remember correctly... Hey, did the audio, go away from me? Oh, shit. budding professional streamer here. I just left it on the pause screen. I got it in time for the reveal, though. Oh, this guy looks awesome. It's like he's got teeth on top of his head. And he's also got he's got pylons. I'm making jokes, but this might be the coolest boss looking yet. All right. Oh boy, oh boy, okay. And we're off to a great start. My guess is that I have to just climb him from around over here. You're noticing a bull theme? Yeah, but this guy actually looks like, this guy's a water bull. Wasn't there some sort of ancient mythology? Oh my God. Some sort of ancient mythology about water bulls. Roman, right? Or is it Greek? Not sure where I'm supposed to climb him at. Also, he keeps turning at the exact same rate that I'm floundering. The Minotaur? Oh, Merminotaur? That'd be odd. That'd be an odd character design concept. You just got a big bulking Minotaur and then a mermaid tail at the bottom. Little shells, regardless, from Little Mermaid. Alright, Billy, I'm gonna read what you wrote here in a minute. I gotta figure out what I'm doing with this guy. Because I keep trying to get, to his arms or whatever, but then he keeps turning. So I'm not entirely sure. I think I might have to swim to, oh boy, the camera's really hurting me here. I can't see, please. I'm trying to swim to this platform over here. Uh-oh. Ooh, God, man, this guy is relentless. If you start making bad jokes again, Ed, I'll need to make a ban Ed command. Well, there's already a ban turtle, so... And there's a count now, too. Jeez. Okay, camera, I'm gonna need you to, stick with me here for, a second. Okay. So now how do I get up there? It looks like you should be able to climb his arms. Maybe this is one of those hide bosses, right? Where you hide for a minute, and then he comes looking, and then you can grab onto his arms? Because that's exactly what it looks like you're supposed to be able to do. I don't know if I can climb any of the geometry around me. Thou cannot aim for its vitals as thou art now. That sounds like a bow reference. Okay, and I can't climb that. Well, that's where I need to be. That's where I need to be. Excuse me, my train's leaving. I need to catch this train. Tri-tongue butthole. Oh no. Don't start that crap. We're almost there. We're almost there. And I got it. Okay, so good. At least it was using the same kind of hiding methodology. Okay, the other thing, Ed, is anytime the camera goes underwater, you gotta hold your breath. Chat doesn't have the ability to breathe underwater. So, if we go underwater, you gotta hold your breath. Okay, I kinda disagree that should have done that. You guys know Xenos? That looks like stuff I'm supposed to knock off. It's like, this really does look like teeth. Like, oddly, looks like teeth. There's no way that I'm just shooting this off with arrows, right? Alright. Well, this is an interesting development. There we go. Gotta get onto his belly. What is it with this? Like, we always end up stabbing them in the head or the belly. Up, get ready to hold your breath, chat. Alright, chat, I hope you're holding your breath. Oh no, I gotta swim to a new one now. Someone needs to tell Turtle. Hey, LDW, tell Turtle that we have another insurance claim that we have to file. Oh man, he's well, I mean, to be fair, I'd be kind of mad too if someone just stabbed the shit out of my stomach. You know what I mean? Like, this is his house, this is his area. I'd be kind of mad too. You'll fix it? All right. Let me know when you're done. All right, let's see. Let's see, I think I can scroll up chat real quick and read this. Alright, so the execution was interrupted when a bunch of hellhounds and drakes started attacking, and the devil was commanding them to try taking the criminal Humsled himself. Oh. Oh, whoops, I got hit because I wasn't paying attention. Alright. I need you to come over here, big boy. There's some pretty accurate shots from that far away. Okay. Alright, and then the party handled the minor threats and went to gang up on the big guy. You had your brother guest star to play the captain as he dueled. That's awesome. Let's see, the devil dominate personed the captain. Yeah, oh yeah, that's the other thing. I wrote it down, Ed. I'm gonna set up a bot, like, almost specifically for quotes so we can have it. We have several come over here big boys and, there's also the, if you're having fun, you aren't living, or something like that. LDW knows what it is. Because I misread Oriana's quote. Or whatever she wrote. This is funny. I'm playing hide and seek with a giant colossus. Yeah, you're not living if you're having fun. That's what I said, and then it took me a minute to realize that I'd said that. That's what happens, man. You're playing League with your friend, and he was laning against Danny. Anybot is like, from what I remember from playing League, Anybot is like one of the more terrifying bots. Like, Anybot doesn't fuck around. Just shouts, "Come here, little girl." Aw, man, that's got a... Alright. Bake your noodle? Yeah. That's not that uncommon of a phrase, LDW. But what ended up happening, Billy? Continue your story, I'm caught up. It is to you, you've never heard it? That's almost as bad as the time that I told Oriana that the check was in the mail, and she goes, "What? What check in the mail?" And then I tried to explain it, and she still didn't get it, and so we had to explain to her that the check being in the mail meant thank you for the assistance. That was one of the few times that you're explaining a joke, and it was funny for the sole purpose of the fact that you were explaining it. Alright, the captain nearly cut the prisoner loose, but the paladin used command to make him halt, and the monk swept the devil's legs to interrupt the spell and prone him. Oh, man. Okay, we can't go to this one here, big guy. Onward, forsooth. You're still waiting for the raven? I don't know what to tell you, bud. Take me to higher ground so I can kill you. Do it. I'm gonna keep hitting your teeth. Can you imagine that? I think that'd be the worst. Like, someone just, like, smacks the crap out of your teeth. Like, when you take a fork and you accidentally ram it against your teeth. We're going the wrong way, dude. Oh, wait. Do I control him? Do I control him from up here? What is this guy doing? Oh, it looks like I do kind of control him a little bit, maybe. Go that way. But in any case, I imagine the, what are we staring at? I do have Tabletop Simulator. Actually, LDW, if you want to do the I'm going to keep doing that. If you want to do the Command Games, that'll give Ed a list of all the games that I have. Alright. You wanna come on up here? Please come up here? Sir, I did the thing. I need you to come up here. Alright, so what happened, Billy? What happened after you knocked him prone? This is kind of strange. Like, I wonder what changed, because, like, this is what we did the last time, and then he came up here. So I wonder why he won't do it now. And I didn't see any more blue on my way up. Gut. What about his gut? Yeah, I'm waiting for him to show me his gut so I can get him, but he's gonna shoot me through the thing again. Okay, sir, I really need you to come up here, please. There we go. Thank you for showing me your belly. I'm gonna tickle it. Alright, chat, I need you to help me tickle his belly. There we go. Thunder of the Lake. That's kind of a cool name. I think this boss is probably one of the cooler designs. I love the whole helmet face. Gut equals good in German. I don't know I barely know any other languages than English. Like, I know, like, a little bit. Like, basically, if I were to get stranded somewhere, I could probably do enough to say, please help me. or, like, let them know I'm hungry or thirsty or something, but that's about it. Pronounced Gut. Oh, is that like Guten Tag? Then that's like you saying good morning? Disclaimer has been added successfully. Why is there a disclaimer? Oh, he makes bad... Listen, we all make bad jokes here. Then the Hexblade and Rogue decapitated the big jerk. Oh, nice. Okay, apparently I've forgotten how to drink water. Or I'm trying to drown myself on stream, which might be against TOS. Oh, what's this? This is new. I think I might need to get a splash guard for my Nalgene. Oh, Ed. Oh, that's cool. I want a mask like that. So are these guys riding to, like, try to stop me? Is that what's happening here? Like, they know what I'm doing and they're riding to try to stop me? You know what? I might take a clip of that guy's mask and 3D print it for myself. This just keeps getting more and more awkward. Okay, so this should be, I think we started with 10. We just took out 2, so that means we're at 12. Look at that, I can do math. How many Colossus are in this game? We've got to be close to the end. LDW, everybody loves everybody in this channel. That's why you guys created the Hug Commander. At least that's what I'm convinced of. All right, who's next? Vast Desert Land, so it sounds like a snake. Called it. It's another snake. You haven't hugged Bill yet? Well, then get on that. There we go. 27 hugs has been given. Nice. Alright, well, that's gonna do it for today's stream. This was, like I said, just a real short makeup stream. Thank you everybody who came out and sat around and bullshitted for an hour. It was great. Talked about D&D and all that good stuff. Ed, I hope that the rest of your day goes well at work. And we'll just be resuming our normal schedule tomorrow at 6 p.m. Central. So, thanks for coming out. You didn't see any makeup? Here, wait, let me put on some blush real quick, right? And, like, do my eyelashes. There you go. There's your makeup. Thanks for coming out, everybody. Have a good night.